First, I will be setting up my tools. On my soldering iron, I will be replacing the tip with a smaller tip so it's easier to solder on the tiny components. First, I pre-tin the solder pads, and that is just adding some solder to the pads. Pre-tinning the pads is a bit easier, because then I can just add the resistor on top and reflow the solder.
Using a pair of tweezers, I place the resistor on the solder pads and reflow the first side. When the resistor is attached at one end, I reflow the other end so the resistor gets attached to both solder pads. After soldering on the resistor, I use a multimeter to check that the resistor is on correctly. And I do this by just measuring the resistance between the two pads. The size of resistor that I use is called a 0805 size, and that is a surface mount resistor. Now I will just follow the same steps to solder on the rest of the resistors. Some of the resistors that I have is even smaller than the 0805, and that size is called 0603. Here you can see a chart showing the different sizes of surface mount resistors. It doesn't really matter what size the resistors are, the process is still the same. First, pre-tin the tabs, then place the resistor and reflow each pad. Here I'm soldering on a 22 ohms resistor, but it is really not needed because it's there just to protect the gate on the MOSFET, but as we are controlling the gate using a microcontroller, we should not have any inrush current that can damage the MOSFET. So you could just replace it with a small piece of wire. Here I'm soldering on a 2K resistor, which is the discharge resistor. And that is the resistor responsible for discharging the MOSFET so it turns off after you are done shooting. Now it's time to solder on the Arduino Nano 3.0, and the one that I purchased online came with these heads, which is quite convenient, because then I can just solder the heads to the Arduino and solder the whole Arduino to the board. And of course, make sure you align the Arduino correctly so that the pins line up with the board just as they are supposed to. Else you can see here, the VIN and ground is aligned with the power connections on the back of the board. Personally, I don't like the header pins sticking out too much, so I just grab a pair of pliers and cut the ends off. Now it's just putting the board back on the helping hands and solder up all the connections one by one. Now, the only thing that is missing is the motor connectors, the battery connectors, the trigger wire, and the MOSFET itself that goes on the back. It is pretty trivial to solder on, so I won't show it in the video. Instead, I'll just show you the final result. Here you see the final result with the MOSFET on one side, motor connector and trigger wire on one end, battery connector on the other end, and the Arduino on the other side.
So now we have the complete finished burst mode MOSFET based on the Arduino Nano. And as you can see here, I'm already working on a smaller version, just like I told you last time that I would. So those videos will be coming out later. The next video I will be making will be a very short presentation of the burst mode MOSFET, where I show you how to program the MOSFET with the code you can find on my webpage and show you the feature so you can see how the burst mode works. So please go down and subscribe. Remember to click the bell icon so that you will get notifications whenever I upload videos, and also remember to share with your friends, because the more followers I get, the more videos I will make. So, thanks for watching.